Hi, this video is made by Salman Hosseini and narrated by Niloufar Iskander from Hyperlyceum team. In this tutorial, we will explain how to define the Vdload subroutine in Abaqus. One of the advantages of using Explicit Solver is the strong capability in contact analysis. In some cases, such as the movement of train wheels on a rail or the movement of a vehicle on a bridge, which require modeling various components, it is beneficial to use the Explicit Solver. To define the complex load distribution or motion of the components for the explicit models, the Vdload subroutine is helpful. In this tutorial, first we introduce the Vdload subroutine and give you some tips, and then we will explain the subroutine using an example of the moving load. And at the end of this video, we'll show the results of the simulation. Vdload is one of the Abaqus Explicit subroutines to simulate the process requiring complex load implementation in Abaqus. The subroutine can only be applied for defining mechanical loads for stress analysis. It can be defined as a function of time, velocity, position, and so on. It is also useful to define loads distribution as 2D for a surface and 3D for geometry. This subroutine will be called at each load integration point for each element of surface during the stress analysis. If you are interested in learning more on how the subroutine works with Abaqus, you can watch the video linked on top. Before explaining the model, let us talk about JL type first, as many students might not be familiar with it. JL type is a parameter that is defined inside the subroutine and determines the type of distributed load. This parameter can be viewed and changed in keywords. JL type number 0 is used for a surface-based load. JL type number 1 is for body force in the X direction, and number 2 for Y, and 3 for Z direction. JL type number 27, which is called PINU, is used for pipe pressure, and part type is wire, and element type should be pipe. And numbers 41, 42, and 43 are used for line load, and part type should be wired, and element type should be truss or beam. Now we move on to explain the moving load example. You can see the geometry model that was created in Abaqus CAE. The length, width, and thickness of the components are 1, 0.15, and 0.02 meters respectively. On the right side, you can mesh the model. Here, the loading area is defined as a circle with a radius of 0.03. The equation used in this example is shown here. L here represents the distance from the center of the circle to the origin of the coordinates. Here, we have a circle with a radius as explained before, and this is the length of our equation. A and B are the distances from the center of the circle to the origin. You can see the result of the stress analysis that is done by using dynamic explicit step. As I explained, the Vdload is one of the Abaqus Explicit subroutines and requires using the dynamic explicit step. Having in mind, we can move on to Abaqus. We start with modeling the part. I want to create a part with a name Part 1. It is deformable, solid, extrusion with an approximate size of 0.2. Continue. I place a node at the center and fix it. I draw a rectangle with dimensions explained before. For the length, we set 1 meter. For the property, we define steel material. Because we are using a dynamic explicit model, we have to define material density. The Young module is 207 times 10 to the 9th. And the potence ratio is 0.28. Okay, we set the properties to the part. We insert the part to assembly and move it to the center using the translate and rotation feature in the assembly module. In the step module, we define dynamic explicit with a time period of 0.026. We move to the load section to define the pressure load on the part. Here we use user-defined options so we can define the Dload subroutine. We set 0 for a magnitude here. We fix the bottom face of the part here. For mesh, the approximate global size is 0.007, which is adequate for this simulation. Now we move to the subroutine so I can explain how to define the moving load for the model. As explained, this code defines the coordinate of moving object or load using the step time and the velocity. Here y0 is a distance from the center of the circle in the y direction. In Vdload code, N block represents integration points of all elements together, which will be analyzed in this simulation. We use X and Y for the coordinates of the integration points. This section is to define the position under the moving object where the load is applying. Here, it shows if the circle contains the material inside it. The subroutine applies a 10 times 10 to the 6th value as pressure. Now we get back to the Abaqus model. We create the job and insert the subroutine file here. We can change the number of CPUs to decrease the processing time. While the simulation is processing, I can explain the usage of the subroutine code. The movement of the train and wagon and iron rail is one of the good examples of this subroutine. Since simulating the components and defining the contact feature between the iron rail and wagon is complicated, it is beneficial to use the Vdload subroutine and apply the load directly to the iron rail. Here, you can see the model that we developed for the rail and sand geometry. We defined the properties based on literature and assembled the components. Here you can see the boundary condition and loading using Vdload Subroutine. This is the last part that shows the model meshing. If you're interested, you can find it on our website and the link is attached below. Now, going back to our model, the simulation is over. You can see the result. I removed the elements to have a better animation quality. You can see the movement of the load based on the stress distribution. Now I select three elements to plot the stress distribution during the simulation. These three curves illustrate the exact time that the load was applied to the components. If you're interested in this video, please check our website hyperlyceum.com. I hope you enjoyed this video and bye until the next one.
This video was made by Salman Hosseini. To find his contact information and his updated resume, please visit our website hyperlyceum.com. Salman is an expert in Abaqus, 3Matics, Mimix, SolidWorks, CATIA, and a few other engineering software. To plan online sessions and discuss industrial and academic projects, please use the provided email under Salman's contacts. The cost of the projects vary depending on the complexity of the work and can be discussed in advance. We look forward to working with you.